So welcome to this video. In this video we are going to see that why in general when whoever have done machine learning before might have no familiar with this term ensemble methods, but let's see the general idea of the ensemble method, what it is. Let's say you have a binary model, and your model does output 1 or 0. So instead of lying on a single model like SVM or naive bias, what we do in real world that we take all three models and calculate what is the probability by this model, what is the probability by this model, or what is the probability of actual by this model, and then we calculate all these value, and let's say we calculate average and divided by, and we will have a confidence by this confidence that the model, if it is greater than 0.5, then the output is 1, or if it is less than 0.5, then output is 0. So this method works because finally, that what we need, what we are doing here, in that we are finding a function that can approximate the relation. So instead of finding one function, we can find f1, we can find f2, and we can find f3 and take the weighted average output of this. So let's say if we have something that is more on the one side, then the all three functions would give you output 0. Something higher, and average would be higher, and you can say with more probability that okay, this is belongs to class 1 or something. So that's how ensemble method helps. Sometimes we actually make a classifier on top of ensemble method and then proceed with that, or sometimes we take a weighted average, like let's say we give W12 logistic regression model plus W2 weight to SVM model plus W3 weight to naive bias model, and then we divide it by it. So these are the methods that we use in machine learning to calculate ensembles. So it's not that we need to learn what is ensemble method. Is I just wanted to give you idea what is ensemble method, and it's sometimes it is not necessary that we need to have different functions to calculate for ensemble method. That this is like logistic regression, this is SVM, this is naive bias. We can have only logistic regressions, and we feed this input, we will have different weights for all these network, and we will have output, and then we calculate the final from here. So this is also possible. So when we have function to approximate to calculate the predicted function, we have what we do in this case, that we calculate, we train our model on different subsets of data or different subsets of feature. So this is the two methods, two ensemble methods that is used in machine learning. But can we apply this same method on deep learning or neural networks? So let's see. This was option one, where we have different architectures, but we are training it on the same data. And as we know that a single neural network architecture, training a single neural network architecture is already expensive, and we are training here three or more networks, and it would be expensive and it would be really hard to train. The other option that we had, that we will have a same networks, but our training subset or training data have different features, or we are training it on different subsets of data, but that would be expensive also, because our network is already dense. So we would want that ensemble features that will have a different networks and it can give different outputs. We want that, but we don't want to apply this trivial method of ensemble. So what other option that we have, we will going to see in the next video.